So let's consider a plain wall that has a length, and remember the length is in this direction. It has a length of 100 millimeters, and it's convectively heated by a fluid that's at T infinity at 750 degrees C, and it's heated on both sides. So it has the same temperature and the same heat transfer coefficient. So the initial temperature of the wall is 200 degrees C. And what's desired is that the minimum temperature of the wall is no less than 500 degrees C. And so the plain wall is heated for 10 minutes, which is 600 seconds, and for that time, or at the end of the time, is this condition met? And if so, what's the minimum time it would take? If not, how long would it take? And so we're going to use the following properties. The thermal conductivity of the wall is 25 watts per meter Kelvin. The density is equal to 7,500 kilograms per meter cubed. The heat capacity is 600 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And finally, the convective heat transfer coefficient, and if you remember I said it's the same on both sides of the wall, is equal to 150 watts per meter squared Kelvin. So the first question is, if we need the minimum temperature to be no less than 500 degrees C, where is this minimum temperature going to be? And well, since the wall is being heated, the last place to be heated is the midplane, or where X equals zero. And if you recall, if you have this kind of symmetric heating or cooling, we say that the wall actually is 2L. And so when we're looking at the length in any one of our calculations, it's actually 0.05 meters or 50 millimeters. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to calculate that BM number. The reason we do is if it is less than 0.1, then we can use lumped capacitance to calculate what we need. So the Biot number, which is H times L divided by K, and so when we calculate this, we find that we have a Biot number of 0.3, and that means that we can't use lumped capacitance. So we're going to need to use the exact solution in the form of an infinite series. However, if our Fourier number is greater than 0.2, then we can use only the first term of that infinite series, and we call that the one-term approximation. Let's calculate that Fourier number. So the Fourier number is what's known as dimensionless time. So it's equal to the thermal diffusivity times the time divided by L squared. And if you notice, we're not given the thermal diffusivity, so we're going to have to calculate it. So this alpha is equal to the thermal conductivity divided by the density times the heat capacity. So our alpha is equal to 5.56 times 10 to the minus 6 meters squared per second. So our Fourier number is equal to 1.333. So this is clearly greater than 0.2, and we can use the one-term approximation. In addition, since we're looking for the mid-plane temperature, in other words, where x equals zero or x star equals zero, then the equation simplifies to the following. So we're looking for that T zero. So we're going to need to find both this constant and this eigenvalue. And so where do we find it? We use a table that has the C1 and the eigenvalue as a function of Biot. So we look at this table and find what corresponds to our Biot number equaling 0.3. And so when we put our Fourier number and our C1 and our eigenvalue into the above equation, what we end up with is that the temperature at the midplane is equal to 350 degrees C. That is not the 500 that we need, so that means that we have to solve for the time that it takes to get to 500. Let's take a look at the same equation, but written in terms of time. So where do we find the time? Well, we find it from the Fourier number. So we're going to have to solve for the Fourier number, and then from that, find the time. So when we write it out like this, we can solve for the Fourier number, which is equal to 3.06. And again, that's greater than 0.2, so we can still use this first term or one term approximation. And from that, we get that the time is equal to 1,376 seconds, or almost 23 minutes, which is quite a long time. So how can we shorten this time? Really, what we're going to have to work with is that heat transfer coefficient, or perhaps changing the fluid, or even having a higher bulk temperature.